just never knew how to tell you.
I would be able to talk about my life.
I ever loved a vodka.
I have two arms.
You want me to say it out loud?
I see a woman from far across the grass. Is she winking at me? Could that be me she's smiling at? And what a smile. You could slice bread with that smile. What if she never meant to catch my eye? A tingly magic is in the air when I spot her countenance. She is a rare and special treat for my soul, my lost, my horny soul. I'm calling out to her. I'm calling out to her in a special, telepathic way. If we are meant to be one, she will hear my song. Does she think I've no place, asking for a date? If I come on too strong, will she get an image of me in her mind of a slobbery lesbian? The first les who ever came on to me was lascivious and bold. I was mixed with turned off, turned on. But I'm not gonna be no miser in the grave. I'm not gonna be no save a penny spinster. I want action. And the squeaky wheel gets the grease.
Hi, Lulu. How are you, honey pie? Did you miss me? Come here, little one. Don't let the dog out, everyone. Lulu. Lulu, guess what I bought for you? Guess. Oh, I know you're so excited about a bat. Yes, we're gonna have a bat for you. Okay.
Hello, it's Dwayne. Come on, pick up the phone. Are you there? Come on, I've been waiting for over an hour. Well, I'm going home now, so if you want, you can give me a call there.
Right. Another annoying phone call. Who's ready for a bath? Okay. Start you up. That's gonna be a whole big project. Lulu and her washing. I don't do it very often, once a month or something.
Cute dog.
Isn't she? She's adorable.
She looks like a
She's friendly. Go ahead, you can touch her. Yeah, she's like a little bullet dog. I like to call her my little bullet dog. Really fell right down outside, didn't it?
Do you always dress up when you go outside?
Well, I mean, I wear the wig and such, but oh my God, look at this. I don't dress up. I mean, right now it's just like a little makeup and, you know, some hair. It's not really much. I get a little tired in the afternoons. I don't mean to be a... Oh, one thing about... These sandals are lovely, but one thing about plastic shoes is they make your feet hurt. I just have to put my feet up for a while. I hope you don't mind. I know it's not...
No, it's fine. Don't worry.
It's not very much, you know, glamorous or anything. I don't know exactly what you're looking for. You can stop me at any time, but I'm...
Just yourself.
Okay, just be myself. No problem.
Thank you.
This is lovely. It's not a picture, actually. It's a photo. A photo of a picture. And I like it very much. You notice he has a jamungus heart on there. Did you see that? So I just thought that was very amusing. And here he is with that face on, and he just says, look at my penis, really. So you do. And then, well, some people come in, and I say, well, look at the lovely picture, and then I see whether they notice or not. See? There's some lovely, it's a lovely couple. Can you get that? Inspiration for me, really, fashion-wise, I think. This period of time. Oh, wait. Oh, I'm sorry. I have to get that because I think it might be a friend of mine. Excuse me, 1 minute. Hello? Hi. Yes? Yeah, well, we're filming right now. I'm in a film. The film that they're doing it. Mm-hmm. Well, no, it's going fine, really, yes. Well, he's asking me some questions and things like that, and... Well, I don't know if I can come now. I don't know if I can make it, because this is going to go rather long, I think, and... Well, Don't start getting whiny on me or anything, because I told you that I might not be able to... Look, I really don't want this kind of pressure on me. Because if I can't go, I can't go. That's just the long and short of it. I can't really make up any kind of excuse about it. It's just the way it is. Because, Dwayne, stop and listen to me for 1 minute. I've been here all day and I'm tired, that's why. But are you listening to me? It's because I said I'm tired. I've been walking all up and down the fucking streets all day long, and it... No, it's not just like having your picture taken. It's very tiring. All right, look, I know I said... Okay, maybe I made a mistake there, and I shouldn't have said that I would come. But I said I would... I didn't want to offend you, because I know that you get your... Look, I can't have this conversation now. Because I have people. I have people all over my apartment. Because I've been... my hair looks terrible. My makeup is falling apart. You can't even know. It's hot with the lights and everything. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Well, call me tomorrow. All right. Yes. I know. Okay. All right, I'll see you tomorrow. Okay. Bye-bye. I'm sorry about that. I'm sorry about the phone call taking up so much time.
Who was that?
That was Dwayne. Didn't I mention... I mentioned Dwayne before, didn't I?
A little bit.
Yeah. He's just my love-hate relationship, you know. He just really, he really gets to me. He pushes my buttons. Now I'm all distracted. I can't really talk too much. I don't know if I can, you know, perform. Oh, I just want to kill him sometimes. Mm-hmm. I'm feeling a little hot in here, so I... And whenever I'm feeling blue, I just like to look at my diorama. It really helps me sleep at night. I go and I have dreams about Italy. And some wild romantic adventure in Rome or something like that. Or Pisa even, I guess, because of the... tower and everything. I don't think I'm going out tonight. I tell you that right now.
Oh.
Look at me. I'm on the bed already. It's 9 o'clock.
leave then.
Okay. Well, I mean, you don't have to leave. You can...
No, we'll let you
rest. If you want the sleeping scene or whatever, have you? I don't...
We'll let you rest.
Okay.
I look into the mirror in this motel bathroom, and I check for signs of imperfection. I think to myself, secrets. And I give myself a wink. For there are things about me he will never know. Things I cannot even admit to myself. Out of the corner of my eye, I see my red hair and the black of my lashes reflected back up to me in the shiny silver of the faucet. Suddenly, everything shiny in this bathroom is winking at me, and I'm thinking, sex, 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 it's everywhere. And yet I don't feel sexy. How can that be? But maybe that's not so unusual. Maybe we all feel a little bit on the outside. For isn't sexuality such a deeply personal thing? And isn't it force-fed to us like some kind of a meal on the airplane? You get two choices, chicken or sirloin, and if you're smart, you called ahead and ordered the no salt or the kosher or the vegetarian. But in the end, doesn't it all taste pretty much the same? But really, really I feel like my dick's been cut off. Explanations? There are many. Perhaps I'm psychologically disturbed. Or perhaps in my past life I was a man, and so as when the arm is cut off and the nerve endings remain, I feel something there that is not. That would be the past life explanation. In any case, it matters little. For I know everything's gonna fall right into place in my next life when I get my dick back. I miss it. I miss the weight of it. I miss the way it feels when I walk. I miss pointing it the way men do. I mean, not actually taking it out and pointing it, but just pointing it in your general direction. And you get the picture. I know it's wrong to want the weenie. I know it's passé even. Penis envy. We were laughing about that 20 years ago. Well, I got a case of it. I got a case of it bad. I look at myself in the mirror, and I see breasts, and I see vagina, but in my hands I feel that I'm a man. I'm a man. I'm a man. I'm as manly as they come. I'm manlier than any man, because I'm a woman. Ain't I a woman? Often I ask myself that question, and often the answer comes back to me as if from far away. No, I ain't. What an awfully hardy woman I am. What an awfully mean woman I can be. And how awfully much I love to love you from afar. So that when I gaze at you from across the room, I get a little pain deep inside my chest. And when you are my lover, how much I still love to love you from afar. So that when your eyeball is here next to mine, I still get that little pain deep inside my chest. Then I give a little laugh to myself. Perhaps you don't hear me laughing. Perhaps you're asleep. But I give a little laugh to myself nonetheless, because you are not so very far away now. You are as far away as my next breath. It's me. It's me who's far away. It's me.
you been okay?
Yeah, I've been feeling all right. I just tired a little. Just a little tired.
Just a little. Yeah, well, that's not so bad then.
No, I can't really complain. Although I get sad every once in a while. That's really how it seems to be going.
You get sad. Well, anyway, you going out at all then?
No.
No?
Why should I? He only just tries to pressure me about everything. I mean, have you noticed that? I mean, you go out with us and he keeps trying to tell me what to do. Have you noticed that?
Dwayne.
Yes. Yeah. Well, what did you bring me anyway?
Oh, to where?
Yeah, let's see.
I just
some
thought
of
I'd
that.
Show you some of these bits. Just a few bits of schnapps, so you know, the usual. Because that upset you with that little
bit. That's very upsetting. Oh, no, what's this? Oh, this is it.
This
Please,
is
don't.
It.
Oh, show me that.
That would go around the back.
Oh,
you kind of lift it up, you find that hole there.
It's only
three
pins. Arm holes.
Three safety pins.
Now, where did you get this one anyway? Make this?
Well, it's a sari. It's a ladies' woman's sari.
I love it. Alright.
Did you hear any more from Dwayne?
Well, he calls. You know, he calls so repeatedly. I don't want to talk about that. I mean, it just gets me upset. You know how that is. I start talking about it, the next thing I'm going to be weeping.
Perhaps you should weep.
Well,
you could weep.
Could weep. But I wept. I wept already. I wept already today.
You should never have an animal in the act, I tell you.
I know.
It'll ruin your career.
It will, but... Well, look at Lulu. All they've been doing is shooting Lulu the whole time I was here.
But we could be in bed together.
Okay.
Good night, Lulu.
Night, Lulu.
That's it.
That's lovely. Look at that. See, she responds so beautifully. She's really my dog.
The poodle. It should be the poodle.
Oh, I hate poodles. I like a little scruffy dog like this.
I don't know. We have to go out more.
Every time you come over here, you say that we have to go out more, but where would we go? I mean, it's not like I'm gonna go to Miami with you and your big jet set.
We could go to the Limelight, the Roxy, we could go...
Oh, I don't know.
That other place that does just disco. We could
what
go to
that?
A mixed club. We could go and have fun. With the men?
Okay, but not today.
All right.
Maybe we can go next week.
You're on.
I mean, maybe if I had something decent to wear, I'd go.
I brought you this.
Well, I know, but I don't.
I've got a nice tiara. This chair, could you have it any lower?
Oh. Is it bad for your back? Or I don't know.
Well,
I find it delicious.
It is a gorgeous chair.
Yes, and it's
like...
It would
look quite lovely on the set.
Well, this is my set. My set to my own movie.
What time is it, Mother? Is it 3:50? For if it is 3:50, soon she will come walking down the sidewalk on her way home from the high school. If it is 3:50, soon I will be seeing her, the teenager with the long black hair whom I adore. Here she comes. What can I give her, Mother? What can I give her to show my love? Please, God. Make my desire tiny. Make it small. Don't take it away from me, God, but make it small so that no one will see it, especially she, God, who is the object of my desire. Oh, make it small so I will appear coordinated. Please, God, grant my wish.
Are you seeing anyone now?
No. I have these certain people I tend to keep gravitating backwards towards. No, I do mean backwards. Well, you know, when you're positive, then people, it becomes a whole big issue. And I'm not interested in any little things. You know, I'd really like someone who would just commit with me for the future and let that be whatever it would be.
It's hard.
Well, yes, I suppose. I suppose. You know, I'm very domestic. I don't know if you can tell. It might surprise you. But I'm a very domestic person, and I'd like to just set up home with somebody. I've been thinking I should go back to Florida, where I'm from, just to visit. I miss it somehow. I miss the swamps. I miss all that brown water. Of course, I wouldn't really like to stir up all those old childhood feelings and everything like some kind of a murky river, but I would like to go back and just see it. I have a prayer for the future. And that is that there will be no more shame prayers for all the little children. And I got news for you. That is that you ain't got nothing on me that I didn't know already. Oh, I'm a big perv. From way back. I'm soiled. I'm a victim of sexual humiliation. Many times over. In fact, sometimes I have opened the car door and sat my ass down in the bucket seat of sexual humiliation and gone for a long ride. So what? And I'm a homosexual. I'm a homosexual. I'm a homosexual. And I'm sick of it. I'm sick up to here with it. So I declare from this day forward that I will follow my sweet tooth towards whatever decay it may lead.
Which means what?
Which means that when my friend brings over an apple pie, goddammit, I'm going to eat it.
Which means what else?
Which means that I haven't been to the dentist in 3 years, and I may need a filling. I don't think I've said it any plainer, Ira. Do you want some apple cake? Do any of you boys want some apple cake?
No, thanks.
It's quite good.
Cut.
It's a cut.